My name's Mark Johnson at JMA Engineering. I'm National Sales Manager. JMA Engineering has two distinct divisions. One's stainless steel fabrication, and the other one is mild steel construction. As the wine industry grew, so did JMA, as we were just well placed in the middle of the wine region to deal with it. And here we are today. The grant was just a great opportunity for us. You know, the timing couldn't have been better. Like a lot of industries, we come off the back of the GFC struggling. And in addition to that, we had to deal with the biggest drought of all time. To combine the two put a lot of pressure on any small manufacturers, particularly in this region. This grant enabled us to have a look at some equipment that could then make us more competitive in other industries and on a national scale. But, you know, it wasn't cheap. And we'd sort of looked at it for a couple of years and we just were struggling a bit to have the confidence to go ahead with it. And then the grant came up and we've seen that as a real pathway to making it all happen. We had a bottleneck in our production line where we had to do a certain task of moving a big stainless sheet of coil manually, and there was no equipment available in the world, you know, 30, 20, 10 years ago. And it was not just the labour intensive, the risk involved in dealing this task was frightening. It was a 10 person task. This Imcar strake maker just took that bottleneck out of our production process and made us much more efficient. We went from having 10 people at risk twice a day or three times a day to zero risk, all based on this machine. So, you know, it's tempting to think about the financial gains of having better production with this machine, but the reality for us was we think it's just been potentially a lifesaver, and the technology was pretty exciting for us. It means we can build bigger tanks, we can build high pressure vessels. It just opened up a whole new field for us.
My name is Tony Costa from Costa Brothers, and I'm the operations manager down here. We spoke with SARMS, we worked with them fairly closely. We demonstrated to them that the need for this facility, why it had to be here, why there was a demand for it. We went through and identified that the industry was at its maximum potential. There was no more room for growers and growth in the industry. So by us putting in the facility down here in the Riverland area with the SARMS grant, it's now taken the pressure off of all the other hullers and shellers. Also, the growers now have room to grow because there is more processing available now. So the industry is very welcoming on what we've been doing. And with the SARMS coming into it, it gave us that bit of breathing space that we could actually achieve what we wanted to achieve. Without that, we probably wouldn't have been here. This created a lot more jobs for locals, up to 35 more positions for people. On the facility here, we've had well and truly over 100 tradespeople come in. So our town and community around here has benefited greatly from it, from as little places as your takeaway shops, right through to your delis, through to the local hotel, which has basically resurrected quite a few businesses.
Paul McGorman's the name. We're here at Thornby, so we're a family business. So we crop about 6,000 acres of cereals, mainly wheat and barley, a lot of hay as well. And then we also have the lamb feedlot, and that's sort of grown over the years as well, so it's developed to now be our main enterprise. We also have a breeding property on Kangaroo Island, so that keeps us busy. We've had a larger master plan for our business, and particularly the feedlot side of things, about targets where we want to get our growth to and when we wanted to reach those. And the grant that we received has really fast-tracked them. We were able to complete an expansion of our yards, another 16 pens we put in out in the feedlots, and now we're up to 49 yards. We were able to increase our grain storage. We grow a lot of the grains ourselves, but then we buy a lot in from locals around the place. And it's just been valuable having the storage to be able to do that. With the grant, we upgraded our feed mixer. The final aspect was upgrade to our sheep yards. And that has been one of probably our biggest benefits there. We put a big shelter over top, a new loading ramp. So now we have lambs coming and going, and we can load them, 400 lambs within sort of 40 minutes, two people. Load it quick and away to the abattoir nice and quick, and all in a safe manner. And that's been a huge labour saving for us. We've just done performance reviews recently and we've got a happy staff. It's a physical job, but we've been able to put some technologies in place that have cut down a lot of the manual tasks working with sheep there. And it's just making life a lot more comfortable there for our employees and ourselves there. So a bit more of a pleasure to work with the sheep. We have our own private label there as well, Thornby Premium Lamb. Back in 2014, we actually entered Australia's Best Lamb competition, and our lamb was awarded, got the title, we won the grand champion. And that then really spurred us on to go, well, let's do something a little bit more with it. We now supply through a wholesaler in Adelaide into some number of restaurants, sort of high quality restaurants there. And we've actually set up a new joint venture company with some restaurateurs in Sydney and developed a range of ready-to-eat meals. This grant here has certainly freed up my time to be able to go work more on the business, not just working in the business. There's a lot of innovative businesses out there within the rural sector, and people are sort of looking to go, well, I know there's next step I want to take, but there's need a little bit of help along the way to do it. And yeah, having programs such as this has really, for our business, and I'm sure for the other businesses as well, has really just fast-tracked a lot of these targets that they want to get to.
It does give businesses that extra hand to be able to expand where they would never have expanded before. It gives them a chance to have a look at new technology, which they would never have been able to do. By business expanding, then we're finding that the towns are building up, people are staying, there's actually things here for people to do.
Small business in the Riverland area has been very, very challenging. And every time these grants are made available, it's like a little shining light. And you see it in the papers and people talk about it, and it makes it feel good, living in the community where there's some positive things happening.